Good morning, everybody. We're out here again on top of our high-rise tower. We're doing a built-up asphalt tear-off and replacement with the TPO system. I'm here with Mike Hartley this morning, and we're going to talk about the tapered design that we're using on this roof system here and how it works for you guys, because a lot of roofers think that tapering a system means just kind of creating a slope and everything runs downhill, and there's a lot of stuff that goes into it besides just that. You have to take into account a lot of factors here. So rather than me try to explain it all to you, I'm gonna have one of the experts do it for you. So here we go.
So today we started our four-way tapered system. It's an XYZ double Z and then fill insulation, so it's a four-panel system.
Okay.
Complicated, but not if you know how to do these. The trick is we started the drain with a half-inch piece of Dezigns.
So where's that? Can we walk on this? Is this? Yep. All right, cool.
So we start with the half-inch piece because the next panel is half to 1.5. So basically we start with that, and then we just build out, and that's 4x4, which fits the taper, and then we just build out. Then if you look here, we miter the corners, so this is 2x panels miter to make a corner, and we just start going one way, two ways, three ways, four ways. We lay all the tapered till it's all down and it's all laid out, and once it's all laid out and cut into place, then we'll start at a wall. We'll lift one row at a time out, two rows at a time maybe, and then we'll start to foam it in and rows, and then we foam it in because it's all cut, done, fit, and it makes it fast. Then after the tapered's on, foamed, we'll come back and foam another layer of half-inch Dezigns. Okay. And then this roof is getting 080 TPO on it.
So basically, we lay it out, we cut our pieces to fit the design that we need for this roof system, and then we pull it up and we'll glue it down piece by piece.
Yep, we'll take one or two rows at a time out and foam them in so it keeps it all locked in nice and tight, and then you just fill it right in.
Okay, cool.
It's like taking a jigsaw puzzle and lining the pieces up in rows, and then taking and putting a jigsaw puzzle back in rows. Makes it quick, fast. Basically, we'll have this area tapered in about a little over an hour, and it'll take us another hour or so to foam it all in, and then they'll drop the Dezigns. So it becomes very efficient the way we do it.
So now, does the insulation value change across the system as it moves out?
Yes, so this system is an average R30, because it starts out at about a half inch thick, and by the time we get to the wall, it'll be 8 inches thick.
Wow, so big difference.
Yeah, so this way here, you get nice slope going to the drains, and that tapered, when you take the two, the way you average it is dependent across the whole roof. It'll add up all the differences, and it'll come up that it's a minimum of an average R30. That's what this job requires.
Okay, minimum of the average R30. So over here in this, you're talking about mitering the corners here. Can we talk about that? How exactly do you get that? Because it looks like there's two different hills that are converging together here.
It's a valley. So what you got is you have like here, this is a Y panel. So the Y panel comes here and you cut this one across. Then you're starting the Y going the other way and you cut that one. So you're taking two panels and bringing them together to form that valley. And that's how you do taper.
Now, is this the most complex a system will get like this, where you're creating these valleys?
Here, yeah, it's four way. That's your harder one. But this has drains that are all set, so it tapers in a couple different directions once we start to get to the middle of the roof. So it gets a little complicated, but okay. As long as you start from the drain with a 4x4 and you line up your panels around, it squares it up nice and square. And then you just got to figure out where your hips and valleys stop. So when it hips, the roof all matches up flush. Mm-hmm. That's the goal.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
And you got a continuous slope going to all the drains. So
basically, you work your way out from each drainage point.
Start from the drain, you work your way out to the high points and create valleys and stuff.
Okay.
And then you want to, because here, once we get to a certain height, then the roof slopes back the other way, going to the next drain. So you got to make sure, just like the ridge on a shingle roof, that the ridge matches.
Okay,
so we do the same thing with the build-up tapered systems.
So a lot of people talk about using crickets and putting crickets into their systems to do that.
Well,
what are your thoughts on a system like this?
Here you can't get crickets between it because the drains are all offset, so you can't line the crickets up.
Okay.
But the taper in four different ways accomplishes what a cricket does.
Okay, cool. So in this system, we're basically not utilizing any crickets, setting up that tapering.
We're also putting in new anchor posts into the concrete deck, which is a safety railing anchor that's going in for a safety for the guys to tie off when they're doing washing the outside walls of the building. There'll be concrete anchored, these steel anchor points folded into the concrete deck.
Oh, wow. So how many of those are we going to be putting in?
I think we have about 10 to go across the roof.
Okay.
So in different locations, guys can tie off to these as a safety.
Sure. Is that for the window washers?
For window washing people.
Wow. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Something you don't really think about, guys, is washing windows on a 15-story building.
And so we're bolting these in. They go in
What did they use before?
They didn't have it.
Oh my gosh.
It's an ad.
Wow. So we're upgrading the safety features for this building too. Now, is the system we're putting in, we're taking out an asphalt system and we're putting in this TPO system. That's changing the weight load for the building, right?
Well, we're taking typical build-up roof with slag probably weighs, slag's around 400 to 500 pounds per square.
Okay.
Or 4 to 5 pounds per square foot. The build-up roof itself is about another 100 or so. So you're somewhere between 500 and 700 pounds of weight coming off the building. And the new system going back is around a pound. It's very light.
Wow.
So you're taking a big amount of weight off the roof. Doesn't matter here because it is concrete deck. But it's just a newer technology roof system. So.
Now, are we increasing the efficiency? So the other day I was on the live stream and I'm talking about how the built-up asphalt roof absorbs more sun and more heat. And now we're putting on a white roofing system. And we're out here in Pennsylvania, so it's a little bit of a colder climate. But what's your take on the change in those
white
qualities?
White TPO definitely reflects the sun. The old built-up roof had a half inches of fiberboard over about an inch and a half of ISO. So you probably had maybe R10 if you were lucky. And now we're putting an average of R30 across the roof. So we have definitely a better insulation package.
Okay.
And definitely the white membrane will reflect more of the heat load off of the building.
So and with the sloping, when the snow comes in and it's going to, you know, because we get it out here.
All draining towards the roof.
It's going to melt off. It's not going to have an issue with freezing.
It's positive slope everywhere.
And then, now, did we have ponding issues that we had initially on this roof? Because I'm looking around and it, you know.
The roof had a little bit of slope before. Now it's got a lot more. At the outside wall, maybe it was about 3 inches thick. And the slope, there was some slope built into the concrete.
Mm-hmm.
But now at the outside wall, we'll be between, depending on where the roof stops, somewhere between 4 and 8 inches.
So okay.
We're definitely increasing the slope of the roof. So. It's not, definitely not flat like it was.
On a concrete deck, is ponding really like that much of an issue to deal with? Like, what's your take on that?
When we tore the old roof off, it was soaking wet. So having this now, plus having the dense deck underneath of it, adds for impact resistance.
Mm-hmm.
Up in the typical 060 that you see in the industry, TPO to 080. It's all just beefing up a much heavier duty roof system. So that's our goal here.
Okay.
Right?
So we're going to beef up basically this roofing system.
Okay. The whole rest of this gets a layer of four. The whole thing.
There we go. A little on-the-spot guidance here from the expert.
Yeah, I may not be the roofing guru, but I've been doing this for 45 years. And one thing I know is tapered. That's a specialty that I know how to do extremely well. So,
yeah, I can tell this is extremely well graded here. It looks like if you were to, you know, take some marbles here and roll it down, they'd all go into that center point there, which is really your goal with any tapered system here. So he's giving the troops around. So you guys, you don't see a lot of harnesses out here right now, but that's because of the walls around this building here. They're extremely high walls. So as we move up and as we start building up this roof, let's talk about safety for a second. Are we going to be, as we build up, we're going to have 8 inches on the side. Are we going to breach that value where we're going to need to harness up here?
Yeah, once we start going and the guys start working in the perimeter, once we get this down, they'll start to put their harnesses on and they'll be hooked up to a couple mobile safety parts that we have here.
Okay, cool. So what's that look like? Like, when do you know that you need a harness on a roof system like this? And when do you know that you
once
don't?
Once you go about 40 inches, I believe, is the OSHA standard. The main thing, about 40 inches high. So right now we're above that. But once we get to putting the roof membrane and we start to foam in around the perimeter, we'll go with the harnesses.
Okay, cool. So as we build it up, the wall's going to get shorter, obviously, around the outside, and we'll start working our safety into that. So how long does this system take here that we're doing?
We need a lot more, 2 4-inch. What's that?
How long does a system like this take to, like, what would a client expect? Like, how big is this roofing system, and how long does it take for them to replace?
This roof is only about 8,000 square feet.
Okay.
But it's very complicated, so it takes 2, 5, 6, 7. It's going to take us about 8 days with about a 7-man crew.
8 days with a 7-man crew for this.
Yeah.
So,
because what we do is we take off one day, we watch our weather to make sure there's no chance of rain. We get down our temporary vapor barrier over the concrete. There is an existing vapor barrier there that we did an adhesion test to. And
what does the adhesion test do for the vapor barrier?
Make sure that the roof is going to stay stuck to the concrete deck. So
we
tested it 3 different ways.
How does that work? There's 3 different ways.
A machine that they foam on, and a piece of plywood on insulation, and it's to a meter, and they lift up and they pull on the handle, it lifts up the plywood until it reaches a certain PSI. And then once it fails, we kind of know what that limit is. So we tested it straight to concrete. We tested it to the old vapor barrier. And we tested then the new base sheet on top of the old vapor barrier. So we tested it 3 ways to see what the best value was. And the highest value we got was actually leaving the old vapor barrier in place.
Wow.
And putting the new vapor barrier over. So now we have a double vapor barrier.
Wow. So what is a vapor barrier? What's that going to do for a building owner? Like, why would they want a vapor barrier?
It's concrete. So with concrete, a lot of times you want to put a vapor barrier down to protect and seal as a temporary roof, number one. And number two, to stop any moisture from driving up out of the concrete into the new roof.
Okay, cool. So with the concrete roofing system, you're going to get a lot of moisture moving through. It's obviously, it's a very porous material. It's kind of like a big hard sponge, so to
speak.
Plus
it acts as a secondary roof system under the main roof system to stop any leaks into the concrete and damage the concrete.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're up 14 stories in the air. The last thing you want is start soaking the concrete deck. And then you start to get rebar failures in the concrete and then structural failure of the building.
Oh, so yeah. Well, that
helps. It helps protect all that.
That's a whole thing, too. So now the concrete roof underneath, what we're doing, is that completely flat? Is there slope in that concrete deck?
How do they? It has a little bit of slope to it.
Okay.
Might have had a 16th or so, but now with the new quarter inch slope, we got plenty of slope on the deck.
So between that, the vapor barrier, and our roofing system, they're going to have plenty of drainage going on here, plenty of slope.
Yep.
Cool. So this is it, guys. This is what goes into a TPO re-roof on a built-up asphalt system. Out here with Mike Hartley, just getting gemstones of knowledge here from somebody who's been in the roofing game for 45 years. Am I hitting that right?
It's 1975.
1975. All right, so this is a rare event.
48 years.
A rare event, my friends. So soak it in, and we'll be coming back at you soon with more information. Let us know if you guys have any questions. We'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching.